Welcome back to this series with me, Fugi. In this video we will look at the changes in the shard phase between the 2nd and the 3rd edition of the Ninth Age.
The basic structure of the shard phase remains very similar to the 2nd edition. You declare all your charges, and for each charge, the opponent makes a charge reaction. After all declarations have been made, you roll for charge range and move the units one by one. Declaring charges is unchanged, however charge reactions have some differences. For stand and shoot, you can only perform this reaction if the unit or weapon has the specific rule for it. This is to speed up gameplay by reducing the number of dice rolls for low impact actions. The hold reactions remains the same. A change for the flee reaction is that the unit can only perform a flee reaction once per player turn. And already fleeing units are not forced to flee. This change makes it easier to catch fleeing units, thus reducing excessive avoidance. Another change is that when you catch a fleeing unit, it's not removed immediately. Instead, move into contact with it as normal, it will be removed in the melee phase. A significant change is in how charge ranges are rolled. In the 2nd edition you rolled 2d6 and added your advance rate. In the 3rd edition you roll 1d6 plus 4 and then add your charge speed value. A model's charge speed is generally the same as the previous advance rate. This means that the maximum charge range is now slightly shorter, from a maximum of 12 inches to 10 inches, but the minimum charge range is higher, from 2 inches to 5 inches. The goal is to promote offensive play. Players can position their units closer to the enemy without entering the enemy threat range, allowing for more tactical advances and flanking maneuvers. Charge moves themselves remains the same. Move forward with one wheel up to 90 degrees allowed. The difference comes when aligning units after the charge. Instead of the previous rather complex alignment process, you now lift the charging unit, rotate it in the air and place it down so that it is flush with the enemy unit and models are maximized while keeping the initial point of contact still engaged. This change is designed to speed up and simplify the game. For failed charges, instead of moving the highest dice roll, you now move the unit's charge speed value. This makes the outcome of a failed charge more predictable and straightforward. That wraps up the changes in the charge phase from the 2nd to the 3rd edition. Thanks for watching.